What it do? It's your boy Dog Cherry, aka The Greater One, and this is Hockey 101, and I'm here to explain the rules of hockey. Gather round, class, because today our lesson is offside! Ever wonder why players stop in front of the blue line like it's an electric fence? It's because they don't want to go offside. Offside is one of the most important rules in hockey. The blue line is like the border of the offensive zone, and to get in, you gotta have the biscuit. The puck must enter the offensive zone before any of the offensive players. And by offensive, I don't mean guys who curse in front of their moms. I mean the guys with the puck. Get it? If an offensive player crosses the blue line before the puck, what's that? That's offside. The puck isn't actually in the zone until it's all the way past the edge of the line. The edge of the line, okay? Not yet. Not yet. Now, to avoid crossing in first, players can straddle the line. If they still have one skate in the neutral zone, they safe. But if they lift that skate up, yep, that's offside. They need to have contact with the ice. Keep that foot down, man. It's not offside if a defensive player tries to send the puck out of the zone and it deflects off his teammate and back into the zone. That's more of like a bad situation. There's also something called delayed offside. If the offensive player doesn't control the puck while going offside, all they gotta do is, you know what I'm saying, back out of the zone and start all over again, kind of like a hockey duo. After the offside violation, they gotta hold a face-off. It's in the neutral zone, unless the refs think the offside was intentional. If they do, then they make you face off in the defensive zone, which sucks for that goal. He is not happy about it. That's offside. Now you know. You're welcome. You graduated to higher education, and I do mean high. Peace! And remember, stay on side, people.
Ain't nothing like playoff hockey, baby.